7 o'clock on December 11th already, and it's called to order the meeting of the Southwick Board of Appeals. In attendance, we have Paul Gregoire, will be a voting member tonight, Dan Tobias, Mike Parent, Bill Liss will be voting, and Chris Mastriani will be voting, and Wendy Cordero. The meeting is a hybrid. It is being broadcast and recorded on Zoom, which we should do this evening. And also being recorded on audio. We will first review the meeting minutes, and then there will be a public hearing at 5:07:10. Immediately after we get our paperwork done. So let's do this. Everybody wants to review the minutes, meeting minutes, and we'll get those out of the way.
Good. We'll do the same get those noted, right? For the dimensional, for the plant lot, all that, for the other variances. Okay. The project. Able motion to accept. It says written.
Motion to accept the minutes.
Seconded.
We have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Minutes from November 27th are accepted as initially put out.
Yes.
I'm not happy that I can keep them. No.
Thank you. You have a fine.
I'll mention again that the Southwick Town's holiday party is on December 15th at 4:30 p.m. If anyone is able to attend. I'm not sure I've been in the past, but it's in the auditorium at 4:30. So we don't need to RSVP anybody or anything. We just
they're bringing refreshments. I think they do some light hors d'oeuvres or something.
You said you were going to get a table. Were you going to get a table and reserve?
We can go over there.
Yeah.
Like get a little spot for us.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to make it.
I have another afternoon gathering, but I'll do my best to show up. I may be talking double, but you know.
Never been there before.
Okay, so we have that.
Mm-hmm. It could be good to show solidarity and show up. Yeah. This is the ZBA cover. So, good. You won't be milking. You won't be doing horses by then. You'll be happy. That's your time off.
Yeah. I left work 6:15 tonight.
You bounced early, right?
Then there was that horrendous drive home. I could meet some bears.
You don't send the horses to Florida for the
yeah.
You don't send the horses to Florida for the winter.
No, I know some people who do though.
Yeah, I bet.
Wow.
All right, I'll start reading the public notice hearing, and by the time I finish, it'll be 7:05. We can get started. Please find the legal notice for the following hearing published in the Westfield News from the Board of Appeals, Town of Southwick, released on November 27th and December 4th. Notice is hereby given of a public hearing to be held Monday, December 11th, 2023 at 7:05 p.m. to hear the petition of Cameron McCorrison for property located at 10 Birchwood Road, Southwick, Mass. The applicant is seeking a front setback of 23 feet, a rear setback of 3 feet, side aggregate setbacks of 12. No, that's not right. Side aggregate, certainly we want side aggregate setback, but we'll get that straightened out. And a side setback of 12 feet, 6 inches in order to build a carport. Tom, this will be a hybrid meeting held in person, blah, 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 Zoom information. So that's all the official stuff to read. So we had a preliminary discussion on this at the last meeting. Mr. McCorrison was good enough to show up, so we answered most of the questions, but let's come on up again and we'll see if there's anything new, which I doubt.
Let's get a chance to kind of review it again. And
is there anything new?
Not that I'm aware of.
All right.
I had one question. Sure. Looking for your information. It's just my curiosity. It mentions mobile home anchors or something. Could you just describe to me? I don't know what those are.
I'm not really sure what they are either. That's what the engineers told me. That's what they.
But they're good enough for 130 miles an hour or whatever.
What 140.
What they are, they're buried. They're like they're buried in the ground to hold down the structure for winds. Instead of just putting some cement, they're a little bit more robust.
Than just footings?
Then just cement pillars or cement with a bolt. They're actually got a chain, I believe, or a cable that goes down below grade to anchor it. That's what they're doing in Florida anyway on mobile homes, just so they don't blow away.
Okay,
so a hurricane.
So it's not a poured. It's not a poured footing.
No, it's a device. It's a device.
Okay.
Sort of like like a big corkscrew leash would be for a dog. So it's sort of like that in simple terms.
Yeah,
but it has cabled. It's cabled.
That, pretty.
It's deep. Hefty, it's deeper.
50 mile per hour certification. I guess.
Correct.
I guess it works. So.
Well, that thing would become a sail.
Yeah. Like the. Gas station,
right. The roofs that come off, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, so there's no.
That's what I understand them anyway. I've seen.
No other.
I know we had some. There's some dimensions that we had to add to this, but
yeah.
Well, can can we go through? Can you show us the print and the what you're trying to put up and why what looking for?
The you want the this
the structure?
Get some pictures of
yeah.
That's sweet. Sure.
Yeah.
And there's nothing there. There's no garage or anything there now.
No, the driveway.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess this is the official public hearing, so it probably wouldn't hurt to go over a few of these things quickly anyway, in case there's
And these are all filed in the folder. Right. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Great things that I have.
Yeah.
The better ones are in the folder.
So I guess yes.
I'm looking at this diagram. What is this piece in here?
That's a piece of grass.
Grass, okay.
When they I don't know why they did that when they built the house, but they have a 10-12 foot section of grass and then the driveway.
The driveway here. And so what is that section? Just the driveway, what's that section?
That's just a line for the measurement. Tell you how wide it is.
So this square is nothing?
This square?
Yeah.
Well, that's the front end. This is grass. This is the driveway. This is the driveway all the way down to the road.
Oh, that's all asphalt.
That's all asphalt.
Oh, I guess that's trying to find out.
Yeah.
So that line.
Not really there. I guess just can you describe the board what the reason they're trying to erect this carport.
Well, it's kind of a hardship on me and my wife she's had rotator cuff surgery on both her arms, so she can't lift over her head, and she's only 4'11" and 3/4".
And she shrunk them.
She makes sure I put in 3/4. Yeah. And I was diagnosed, I went in for a colonoscopy and they all panicked there. I guess I have aphid. I never knew it, but they all, and I've been seeing a cardiologist, Dr. Pizzou, and he recommended that I don't move snow.
Yeah, so, we happen to live in New England where we get snow now and again in the wintertime.
Well, thankfully, we're not going to get that much this year.
Yeah, we'll see.
See.
Okay. And that structure is open, I believe, correct? It's just covered on the roof, right? So,
I got past that.
What size is it?
Yeah.
20 by 25.
So it's basically like a two-car garage.
Yeah, it's actually a little bit narrower,
right?
A little deeper than
right.
Two cars.
It's just the way it's laid out. Okay, yeah. 20 by 25. Okay,
they were attached to it,
and it's going to be anchored, but it's still with those anchors. It's actually removable. It's not. Yeah, it's not permanent.
Yeah,
and that's probably why they're doing it that way. So it actually is not permanent. They're not pouring. You know what I mean?
Into that.
It's just
part of
that. Yeah. Okay. And what is the zone there?
28.
So there's a lot of not meeting.
Yeah, there's a form that he listed, and there's two
more
that we'll have
right.
to clean up.
Okay, I don't see. Any other questions? Paul, you got questions, or you guys, any concerns? Or
I was trying to figure out
yeah.
where that was attached. Yeah. To a building, that's why I was looking at those, asking those questions with the grasses.
Yeah, it's not
grass and driveway. It's self-standing.
Correct.
Accessory building.
Correct. It's not going to be attached to anything. Okay. Mike, any questions?
No.
I think there's a valid.
It's like a pretty simple
reason and kind of straightforward. So
straightforward, and
but we've got some variances to kind of consider here.
Yeah. My concern might have been if it were permanent.
Correct.
Yeah, I think there's plenty of Cameron, there's a lot of examples of other people that have done similar things mm-hmm. in his neighborhood. And,
yep.
You know, it's pretty much necessary to have some kind of protection over your vehicle. So,
yeah.
And then obviously when the
safety
houses were built back in the 50s, that wasn't as much of a much of a requirement, but I think that it's something we've looked at in the past and haven't had a problem with it.
Yeah,
a lot of houses in that neighborhood are all grandfathered in with garages and other things.
There. Yeah,
do we want to read in a motion?
I
you get the paperwork.
I will make a motion to grant 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 variances. Everybody okay with that?
Yeah. Got to read through.
Okay with letting me do the math here. Okay, I make a motion to grant the following variances to 10 Birchwood Road for the purpose of constructing a carport. A lot area variance of 64,800 square feet. A lot frontage variance of 170 square feet. A front setback variance of 24 feet. A side setback variance of 13 feet. A side aggregate variance of 43 feet. And a rear setback variance of 3 feet. I think that is it.
Okay, let's sit back and one second.
Why did we need a front setback?
We'll read him one more time.
So what he's doing in
the
house. Is it a 28?
Is that correct? It really doesn't have anything to do with the particular carport. He's just bringing it into
cleaning everything up.
Yeah.
Cleaning up the house.
So the house is
in.
But
we're
having less than 75 feet. Yeah. This is 76 feet, so I don't know where
you're going. I guess front is 24.
Okay.
From the front or the rear?
Front. Front setback. So just, unless I can't read.
Hold on.
Rear is 42.
Chris. You got the map there, or the drawing of the building in that packet?
It's all saying it's 76 feet back already.
Total after, that's the total after what? What are you asking?
There were two sets of measurements, one was in the middle of the road. And I was informed that, I guess,
15 feet.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah.
Pretty sure.
I said
76 in the middle of the road?
Yeah.
So we've got a 61.9 here.
Right.
To the edge, 51.9 to the foundation.
So you're right. Okay, I just want, you're clear? Okay.
Yeah, I wasn't sure where to measure.
That, exactly, no, believe me, nobody really is. We go there all the time. It's not the grass line in front of your driveway.
The road's wider than the other, so I figured the middle was.
Okay, so we got a motion with all your variances. I'll second that.
We have second?
Yes.
We'll take a roll call vote, Paul? Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes or no, I'm sorry.
This is the I portion.
Yes.
I or yes is good. Bill?
Bill List, aye.
And Chris Mastriani, aye. So the motion passes to grant variances. You're all set. The rules are.
That's the easy part. Now you got to pay for it and put it out.
Well, that's already paid for.
There you go.
I think you know what the rules are.
20 days, it's got to sit. And then they'll bill to issue the permit, building permit.
So don't go there for 3 weeks.
Correct.
Yeah, we write the decision out formally, submit it to the town clerk. It sits there for 20 days. And then you are free and clear to go.
Will they send me any notification when time's up or?
I check it.
Come down and, okay.
Yeah, put a calendar mark and then, you know.
I'll mail the variance out to you.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much.
The variance will come, but that should, may not be in the timing. For the 3 weeks, you may be able to get started before that shows up, is what I'm saying. So if you calendar 20 days from today, you should be able to come to building permit and say, I heard this was decided then, I want to do it. Because the variance may still be working through politics to get to the.
Because I have to, I believe I have to register it.
Correct.
Registry of deeds.
Yep.
Registry of deeds.
But that'll give you the clearance to do that once you have that.
Right, do I have to wait 20 days to do that?
Yes.
To do it?
Yes. Because in case somebody comes to combat it, you don't want to register it and have a big fight and have to pull it back, but you should be fine. I don't, you had, we did the butters and.
Yeah.
I don't, there's quite a few in your area, so I don't think there's going to be a problem, but it's just, yeah. So we have to do with just the rules, so.
Okay, yeah, sure.
All right?
Fine, yep.
But portion of you get approval is all set and you're good to go.
Okay.
Easy, right?
Yeah, now it is.
Painful. We try to make it painless.
Right, well, yeah, it's.
Join the gym, so instead of all that shoveling, you.
That's right.
What helps is you did some of your homework. I know the variance, they're very complicated at times, so believe me, nobody ever usually gets those right, but you had 95% of them.
Well, it took me a while to figure it out.
Your due diligence was appreciated because it was pretty well laid out and why, and like I said, hardship is very legible and very understandable, so.
Okay.
All right, we'll take care of the paperwork now. We've got the master, we've got the official one here, so. Oh, yeah. Oh, you could, all your back. Yep. Yep, you're good. All right.
Thank you very much.
You bet. Have a good evening. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Merry Christmas to all of you.
So you get that installed right before the first year there about.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you will.
64,800 lot area.
One of the most we've had ever in variances. Seven, I think seven might be a record of how many variances we have. 28, you're going to run to that. Yeah, exactly.
Right side setback variance of 15 feet. Rear setback of 3.
Have a good evening.
And the side edge of the variance of 3 feet.
It's kind of amazing how all those things got in there and then the zoning laws afterwards made them.
They were built way before.
Sort of illegal.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, is that the business?
That's all business. Any new business coming up? No new business. So 2 weeks from today is Christmas, so I don't think we'll have a meeting then.
Well, hopefully we'll get to see everybody Friday. We all can make that.
Okay.
I want to put a motion to adjourn then.
What's the next date for the meeting?
It'll be January. Sorry, time out. Yes. Sorry. Class still in session?
So it's January what?
A possible meeting. It's good on your business. It'd be January what? It's 8th, if.
We have any business.
If there's any business, okay.
When you going south, Mike?
What's that?
When you going south?
March.
March, okay.
Yeah. And my hand operated on my.
Yeah, how's it going, Mike?
Oh, it's sore.
Yeah, I bet. They scrape them pretty good. Like I said, they go in there and.
Yeah.
They don't mess around.
But this too shall pass.
Is it tingling? The fingers tingling or?
They feel like they're like burning, like you've had.
Yeah, scraping nerves.
Yeah. So you're not supposed to be doing anything. And of course.
Right. No golf in this winter.
Driving the car, no golf.
That's all you, right? Yeah.
Somehow the dishes have to get done.
Sure. Just buy plasticware and throw it out. There we go.
Yeah, use all that plastic stuff.
Yeah. All right. Is that it? Can we do motion to adjourn now?
Second.
Seconded?
I seconded.
And I have a motion to adjourn. Everyone in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thank you, everyone.
Go home, mate.